Hello and welcome back to Teacup Tarot. In today's video, we are going to be looking into what messages you need to receive at this point of time. Now, I'm not really specifying this as messages from your spirit or from your higher self, ancestors or past loved one. I'm just going to allow whatever is supposed to come at this moment to come through for all of us. Having said that, you have three piles in front of you. Please pick one that really speaks to you, or more than one if you are called to it, and then we'll start with pile one. Hello, and if you've selected pile one, then these are the messages that you need to receive at this point of time. Now, I believe for you, pile one, at this point of time, life is telling you that you need to learn something. You probably need to learn how to be a little less trusting. You need to learn how to not open your hearts for just about everybody. Your hearts are special, you are special, and you finally need to learn that. Okay, so safeguard your heart is something that is coming forth for you. And of course, it is also telling you to remain open to life's teaching. When something happens in your life, something repeatedly happens in your life, maybe it's time to take a step back and ask yourself, what is life trying to teach me that things are coming into my life on a repeated basis? Same lessons over and over again. Ask yourself, what is it that you're meant to learn? Yeah? What I feel, pile one, is at this point of time, you are people, you are very much in tune with the universe. The sense I get is you've almost opened your life to the universe. You are like almost in this mode of surrender where you are like, okay, universe, wherever you want to take me, I am ready to go. And as a result, what is happening is the energy of the universe is flowing through you very, very beautifully. Okay. And as a result, what is happening is there are many souls that are coming into your experience at this point of time. So your job at this point of time is just to give, of course, to give to people who really, really want things from you, but keeping your boundaries in firm place. Like, don't really be that person who opens yourself so much that in the end you remain with an empty cup. Okay, so only give as much as you're able to give, and then, you know, give yourself a little bit more. That is what is coming through. But either way, I do believe you have surrendered a lot of yourself to the universe, and the universe is beautifully taking you exactly where it is supposed to take. But you really have to become a slightly bit smart when it comes to matters of the heart. Yeah, it doesn't really have to be relationships. It can be friendships. It can be, you know, your work relationships. But those are the areas that you need to be careful about. And what I feel here is, when it comes to opportunities in your life, when it comes to, you know, things that need to happen, for you, it'll be better at this point of time to take initiative and make things happen rather than waiting for something to happen and then you will react to something. Okay, don't do that. Take the initiative. If there is a message that you need to give it yourself very, very clearly, and don't really wait for somebody else to reach out to you. Okay, now again, when it comes to your work situations, if there is something that you want to achieve, make sure you are putting in 100% towards it rather than waiting for it to come to you. Okay, that initiative, that action for you at this point of time in your life is going to be extremely, extremely important. And once again, it is important for you to realize that you yourself are a great treasure, okay? Like, inside yourself, there is almost so many gifts out here that, you know, you just need to explore within yourself when it comes to, you know, beautiful things when it comes to life. Okay, so when it comes to answers, when it comes to looking for things, don't look outwards. You really need to look inwards. If you need guidance in your life, look inwards. If you need support from anybody else, firstly trust yourself to give yourself that support, and then rely on other people. But I do feel, pile one, you already have a lot of support in your life, okay? And I believe for you, just recently, you have completed a journey, okay? There is almost a sense of karmic completion here that I really feel like. So maybe there is a possibility that some relationships may have come to an end. They have come to an end because, you know, you've done your part, okay? The journey has been complete is what is coming. And now it is time for you to go within and ask yourself, what next? And ask the universe, what next? Yeah, that is what is coming. And yes, absolutely. The universe is trying to tell you that you need to now surrender unhealthy relationship patterns. If you are somebody who's very giving, or you are somebody who constantly remains available to people, even who do not deserve your attention, then you know that is something that you really need to work upon. But at the same time, you also should be cherishing people who are constantly there in your life, you know, who are constantly available to guide you, to support you, and to cherish you is what is coming through for you. Of course, at this point of time, you are being asked to surround yourself with people who are exceptionally positive, people who really light you up, okay? And any toxic relationship, any toxic bonds in your life, you are being asked to let it go one final time. Yeah, and once again, you are also being asked to surrender negative thinking. So what happens is, sometimes when life brings us something, you know, and we are not really happy with it, we then go into a pattern where we feel like, why me? Why is this happening to me? This always happens to me. You know, the negative thought patterns. So basically, at this point of time, you are being told that you need to surrender the negative thought patterns and replace them with really positive ones, because it is only the positive thought patterns that will create a beautiful future for you. Also, let me remind you, if you have been constantly struggling from negative thought patterns, you really need to look into affirmations. You really need to keep repeating things again. Repeat to yourself, I am worthy. I deserve all the beautiful things in life, and I am enough. You know, you need to constantly repeat things like that. So please make sure you are really repeating affirmations for yourself. And yes, yes, absolutely. Like I said, you know, you've recently completed almost like a karmic ending. But understand, when things come to an end, it is only because some other beautiful things are meant to start. If some people exit your life, it is only because many more beautiful people are meant to take its place. Okay. All of us are honestly in a soul's journey. So instead of looking at people as people, look at them as souls, and you will probably have like a better time dealing with situations, is what I'm really getting here. But once again, Goddess Kali is here. So I believe she is trying to actually remove people from your life who do not belong there at all in the first place, okay? So sometimes what happens is, because of our karma, because of certain wrong steps on our part, we actually start associating with people who are actually not good for us. And then, you know, if you have like that source energy which is really, really benevolent towards you, then that energy steps in, and in your case, it is Goddess Kali setting in and telling you that I am here to release the old so that the new and the more beautiful can enter your life. Yeah, and again, you are being told to make time for meditation, to make time for prayer, because what I feel has happened to you is, because of your giving nature, because of, you know, your heart being so open all the time, you know, you're so giving, you're so generous, you've slightly imbalanced your heart chakra is what I'm getting here. And for that heart chakra to really heal, you need to sit in prayer and you need to ask the universe, you need to ask your gods to heal you. To heal you and to release some things away from yourself so that you can then move forward to something better. And of course, meditation is absolutely crucial for you. Repeating the name of a god or goddess or any being that you're called to repeat, you are meant to do that, because that will really help you balance your energies and get you back in alignment. Yeah. And once again, see what I see here for you, pile one, is everything that you've sown, all the good things you've done, everything that you sow with a generous heart do, you're going to see it fulfilling very, very soon. Sometimes, you know, in order for the beauty to come in, for the positive to come in, for the best people to come in, certain weeds need to go out of your life. And I believe as you move forward, that is exactly how things are going to happen. So at this point in your life, the weeds are being pulled out so that, you know, beautiful flowers, beautiful trees, and beautiful plants can bloom in the garden of your life. So it's going to happen for you, whatever it is that you're trying to manifest. So don't give up hope. So right now, the time for you is to focus on yourself, to give yourself what you need. And for you right now, aromatherapy can be really, really helpful, especially if you're struggling with your nerves, especially if you're struggling with stress, or if you're struggling with certain emotions, okay, emotional energy. So lavender is very good, sandalwood is very good. And you know, for me personally, I really enjoy lemongrass. Like lemongrass just, for me, brings that energy of freshness. And freshness is exactly what you need. So get into that. And of course, if you can, the place that you're living in currently, or the space that you're holding, please sage it, because saging that is again going to be very, very important for that well-being of yours and for your aura to be really, really clean. Yeah. Overall, those are the messages that you need to receive at this point of time, wherever you are in your life's journey. All my prayers and all of my good wishes are with you, Pile 1. You're going to get whatever it is that you want, because you have definitely, you know, Goddess Kali showing up. And when she ends things, she's only there to begin more beautiful things for you. I'll leave you here. I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello, and if you've selected pile 2, then these are the messages that you need to receive at this point of time. Now, pile 2, what I believe is, right now, whatever is happening in your life, it is fate, okay? It is destiny. This is meant to happen to you in a way that it is happening. Sometimes it is the most beautiful things, but sometimes it is the most unfair things. So when beautiful things happen, it is because of certain really good things that you've done. And sometimes when things happen that can be slightly unfair, it is always a result of your accumulated karma. Okay. So right now, your job is to just go through it, experience it, and let it go. And give it a blessing, so that whatever goes will not come back, and whatever new is to come in will come back, come in with a lot of beauty. Okay. And once again, don't give up on the process of manifestation. Whatever your life you're trying to create, keep creating it, keep living the way you are living, because honestly, pile twos, you guys are fabulous. Keep doing you. Sometimes things work in a different manner, sometimes they work in a divine manner, but everything has a reason. Okay, nothing happens in a life without a reason. So please remember that. Yes. And as you move forward when it comes to your life, please ensure you're putting one foot in front of the other, one foot in front of the other, and just be a little bit careful. So don't do anything impulsively. Don't do anything that you'll regret later. Go one step at a time and you know, you'll be fine. All right. So just take care of that slightly. Okay. And once again, you guys are very, very generous. So when you feel like you need to give to somebody, give with an open heart. Give because it is job right now for you to give. Okay, and especially if you can donate some money, if you can donate food, if you can donate anything to poor, to the needy, to a children's home, to the birds, animal spirit, anything, just give. Because right now your job is like that of the sun. You know, the sun just gives and never gets back in return. So right now that is your job, especially to people who really, really need it. You know, the needy ones who don't really have what you have is what is coming forth for you. And you are being asked to not really, you know, worry too much about change, because change right now for you in your life is actually good. Okay. So whether this is a change in your job situation, whether this is a change in your health situation, or this is a change in your relationship situation, have faith that the universe is taking you exactly where you're meant to be. Okay. And just surrender a little bit, you know, surrender to your journey. Journeys can be all kinds of journey, but if we surrender, the journeys become easier. Okay. So don't be afraid of change. Everything that is happening for you is happening for your highest good. And at this point of time, the most important thing for you to surrender is your addiction. Now, whether this is addiction to, you know, viewing things online all the time, whether this is shopping, whether this is people, or this is food, or this is, you know, just working too much, or certain substances, you need to be able to maintain healthy boundaries between your addictions and yourself, and find ways to let it go out of your life finally, okay? And once again, try to lead a life that is very, very healthy. So if there is a certain diet that you're taking up right now which may not be healthy, it is time to look into a new diet for yourself. Include more fresh things, include more green things, and give your body whatever it is that it needs, yeah? Make sure you do that. And please don't stay indoors for a very long time. You guys really need fresh air and sunlight. Please give yourself that, okay? Because that will shift your mood completely, is what I'm getting at. And one thing that you have to learn to manage as you move forward is your emotions, okay? So what may be happening for you, or what could be happening in the next 1 week, is you feel like your emotions are fluctuating, like you're not able to think clearly. It happens because, of course, the planets are, you know, acting that way as well. But if that happens to you, whenever you realize that is happening, come back to yourself. Come back to that core of your being. Come back to the source that lies inside of you. And just focus. And the best way to focus is breathe. Just deep breathe. And focus on that deep breathing for at least 5 minutes. Till your thoughts are silenced. Till you feel like, you know, that up and down of emotions, that is silenced. But learn how to silence yourself in a better way. Okay, this is inner silence and inner peace that I'm talking about. You don't always have to do meditation. Meditation is excellent. But just at least breathe, you know. Just breathe. Simple as that. Because that's really important for you. You need to be very, very laser focused right now in your life. But when thoughts waver, emotions waver, you need to bring it back to, you know, that proper place where it needs to be. And sometimes in your life, if you feel like you're entering territories that are slightly unfamiliar to you, or if you feel like you're entering certain emotional zones or zones of thought that are unfamiliar to you, you need to trust the process slightly more. Because sometimes, you know, life takes us to deserts, sometimes life takes us through beautiful, you know, seashores, and sometimes life takes us through Amazon jungles, okay? Trust life as long as you trust that everything is happening exactly the way it is happening. As long as you trust your spirit guides and your angels, you're going to be absolutely fine. Yeah, just trust, be more trusting. Yes, and whichever path you're taking right now, as you move forward, you are going to enjoy success in your life. You know, this is the card of the sun. So, you know, like I said, you know, like the sun, you need to be generous. So just like the sun, you will gain the prominence that you seek. Okay, especially in government jobs, if that is something you're looking into, then you're definitely going to get a lot of success. But in whichever areas of your life, whether this is your personal life, this is your professional life, you are going to get the peace you need. You're going to get the happiness you deserve, and nobody is going to take it away from you. Okay, whatever is yours, nobody can take it. Always remember that. And you need to ground yourself, okay? Of course, your energies are slightly wavering, or they may in the future, especially clouded thinking, like you don't know what to do, which path to take. At that time, don't do anything. Just ground your energies. Or just smile, you know? Just sit down and smile. Because smile is something, when you smile, like your insides cannot help but smile. So try the smiling meditation, because it's really, really good, okay? And please take care of your root chakra. Your root chakra really needs to get back into form. Yeah, just walk barefoot if there is nothing you can do. Wherever you live, just walk barefoot. If you can go outside and walk, you really need that. But overall, I do see you have a lot of blessings. You're already very blessed in your life, is what I'm getting. Yes, but you really need to pay close attention to your relationships. What kind of relationships you allow in your life, and what kind of relationships you should actually be relying on, okay? Because I believe the way you, like, you know, associate with certain people may need a little bit of work here. People who are tried and tested, stick with them, because they are the people who are going to be with you for the long haul. Yeah, assess your relationships. Don't allow people to come into your life very easily, okay? Don't give your trust away very easily. Especially right now, wherever you are in your life, okay? So, you know, be a little careful when it comes to meeting new people or making, you know, changes when it comes to your relationship. But assess some things about your relationship, because that patterns need to change. And I also believe you're emerging as a very strong person pile too. So I believe the way you approach situations as well is going to change. I believe as you move forward, you're going to be able to put your foot down strongly. And demand respect where you feel like respect is due. So that is the change that I really see happening for you, especially because you've chosen the sun and especially because you have the yellow one as well. You know, the solar plexus region, I really feel that. But for that to be, you know, properly working, you need to ground your root chakras, because without a firm root chakra, no other chakras on the top will function in a way that is good, you know. And without a firm root chakra, relationship success and success in finance don't come very easily. So always first thing you need to do is pay attention to your root chakra. So overall, those are the messages that I'm getting for you when it comes to what is it that you need to hear today. As always, I want to leave you with a lot of blessings, lot of good wishes, and genuine prayers for a beautiful future of yours. I'll leave you here. I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello, my beautiful pile threes. And first of all, I have to tell you, you know, your life is about to transform in more ways than one. Changes are coming towards you so rapidly, I cannot even tell you. And everything that is happening in your life is to help you emerge from your cocoon. It's to help you emerge from your shell. It's like everything is happening so that you can learn to take risks, so that you can learn to put yourself out there in a much more stronger fashion. I believe a life in itself has grand plans for you. And you right now are just being asked to trust the process and follow the universe wherever it is trying to take you. Because whatever is happening in your life, it is happening for a grander reason is what I see. Lot of opportunities are now going to be coming into your life. So make the most of those opportunities is what I want to tell you. And let me tell you, whatever changes are happening in your life, it is happening under the protection of spirit. It is happening under the protection of angels, and you're just surrounded by all the beings of light and goodness, okay? So whatever you're doing right now, whatever you will be doing, you know, in the future, it is very divinely guided. It is almost fated. Like, I believe even before you were born, this was something that was decided between your higher self and spirit. And you are exactly walking that path. So surrender, let the universe take the control, because, you know, you're just exactly going in the right way. And your job is to just accept the truth, your truth, okay? Nobody else's truth. Because sometimes what happens is, as souls, we are very different. So what somebody else perceives as their truth will not be your truth. It doesn't mean the other person is wrong or you're right. It just means your truths are different. And at this point of time, I also believe you're very, very guided when it comes to your ravens, okay? Raven can of course be your spirit animal, but of course you have a lot of ancestral blessings in your life. And all the changes are also being, you know, looked upon by them. And let me tell you, you're stronger than you think you are. If you feel like, you know, you cannot handle things in your life, or you may not be able to handle this journey, you're built for it. You're born for it is what I'm getting here. Okay, you're almost like this priestess, or you're this priest of light and beauty and goodness. So now is the time to accept your rightful position in the universe. Yeah, don't be afraid and trust your intuition. Absolutely. Trust your intuition. If you have a gut feeling about something, rely on it. If you're getting strong dreams, trust those dreams, because how else will spirit talk to you, right? If you have like an inner knowing, trust it, because those are the things that will guide you forward, okay? And again, you need to work with your inner voice. Do not ignore your inner voice, especially not now, is what is coming forth for you. So it's almost like, you know, the third eye that is connected over the universe, that's opened for you. And once again, you'll be very, very, you know, channeling will come very, very easily to you at this point of time. So if you're new to channel, please channel. Just try, you know, write things down. You'll be surprised what comes through. Okay, but trust your intuition and trust those moments where you're receiving that kind of guidance, and you're absolutely heading into a very successful time in your life. You're going to be experiencing abundance, you're going to be experiencing success, and you're going to be able to come out of any difficulties that you've been facing so far. And let me tell you, if any new opportunity shows up in your life, accept it with open arms. Of course, use your discretion, use the voice that is guiding you all the time, your intuition. But you need to be more open is what is coming forth. The time to play small is gone. you're meant for larger and more beautiful things, especially creative things. Okay, so especially if you're now getting into things that you've never been into, like whether this is painting, whether this is drawing, whether this is crochet or whatever creative, you know, music, artistry, because I believe you're going to be heading in that direction a lot more. And maybe that is the way your soul wants to express itself. Okay, so please get into drawing, get into channeling, get into scribbling, doodling, because that is how, you know, your gifts will come out, is what is coming through. And you have multitude of gifts. I've said that again and again, and you guys are anyway magical. But at this point of time, I also feel like you're going to be getting into multiple things, okay? One day you want to do this, second day you want to do that, third day you want to do that. But you're actually going to be good at a lot of things. So don't be afraid to juggle things, and don't be afraid to try new things. Even if you fail, it's okay. But what if you succeed? Don't get back, okay? Just try till you know, find what is right for you. Experiment a lot. Rely on the inner voice. See, look at this card. This person has like a blindfold, and he's trusting himself to juggle. That is exactly what you need to do when it comes to your life's journey at this point of time. Yeah? And once again, you're going to be receiving very important information. But that information is not going to come to you from anybody else. Not me as a channel. No other channel is going to tell you anything. It's all going to come directly to you. So please make time to connect to divinity, to connect to your own source. So if you can just light sage, light Palo Santo, create that atmosphere where, you know, communicating with spirit, communicating with angels and your guides and all beings of light becomes easier. So create that space and create that atmosphere, because in that atmosphere, I believe you'll be able to learn things more clearly. In a way, you're also going to be shedding old skin and taking up new skin entirely. So this could be like an end of an old way of life, old way of being as well, at the beginning of something entirely new. But you're ready for it. But before that, clean your space. Because what happens is, you know, especially the beings of light, they enjoy a space that is clean, because they are pure beings, right? So if you actually want to invite pure beings in your life, if you want to invite that energy of light, keep your space clean every single day. So if you can, when you get up in the morning, you know, make your bed, clean things around, wear clean clothes. If you have old clothes, give them away. That's old energy, right? Residual energy. Especially if you have clothes that you've been wearing where you were sick, give it away. Make space for new. Energy-wise especially, okay? Because you really need to clear a lot of energetic debris from your space, okay? Not from your body, is what I'm getting here. And of course, you know, you really need to bring humor into your life. You need to laugh. You need to have fun. So whether this is watching funny movies or connecting with a friend who always lights you up, or just going somewhere that your heart is filled with so much joy, do whatever it is at this point of time that will make you happy. Spend time with kids. Spending time with kids makes me very, very happy. They just have this beautiful energy, you know, and that is the energy that you need. Energy of happiness, energy of play, energy of fun, especially because you are the creative type of spirit, you know. So bring more fun into your life. So do something fun for yourself. Life doesn't have to be serious all the time. No fun is there. Spirituality doesn't have to be all serious. It can be fun. So just have fun is what I'm going to leave you with. And as always, I have nothing but my best wishes to send your way. And I leave you with peace, happiness, and fulfillment. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.